My first recipe for today is something that when I mention to you, you automatically think festive, lasagna. For the meat sauce of this lasagna recipe, you'll need lasagna cooked according to package directions, olive oil, butter, chopped garlic and onions, ground pork, ground beef, tomato sauce, white wine, beef cubes, sugar, bay leaves, ground nutmeg, salt, pepper, and water. To make the bechamel sauce, you'll need butter, sifted all-purpose flour, water, evaporated milk, salt, white pepper, and nutmeg. Let's start off with some olive oil and some butter. I'm going to make a meat sauce. I have my garlic, pre-portioned already, okay? I have my onions. Yeah, let's perk up the heat a bit. Yeah. Now we will add our ground pork. Now that the onions and the garlic are kind of wilted, we've extracted the flavor, we add in our ground pork. Okay. Yan. And our ground beef. What I do is I leave it like this for about siguro mga 3 minutes until the other side is already brown. Then I start mixing, no? Yan. Okay, slowly. This requires patience. You have to mash it and ground it, no? This one's done. We will add in our tomato sauce and cook this. Cook our tomato sauce. Okay. Mix this very well. We will add in our white wine or Chinese cooking wine if you want. We have some cubes, beef cubes or pork cubes. And then we mix all of these together well. Cook the tomato sauce. Okay. And okay, at this point, we add in our little water. You know, don't worry about the water. Kasi what we will do here is we let it evaporate until the flavors concentrate. Then we add some sugar just to neutralize the acidity of the tomato sauce. Okay. We add in some bay leaf. Nutmeg, so salt, okay, and pepper, yow, okay, and you know what we will do here, we'll just wait for this to evaporate, and then let's start making the bechamel sauce. Second part of the lasagna, yung bechamel sauce. Actually, it's also very simple, no? But like I mentioned, be prepared, be organized. Butter. Yes, we add in some flour. Okay. And we will cook the flour. We add in our milk, evaporated milk. Okay. And then our white whisk. Okay. Yeah. This requires patience. Eh. Okay, what we will do. We will add in our water. Season this with pepper, salt. You know, you're trying to make it as white as possible also. Yan. And then we add in our nutmeg. Okay. Yan. Two things we're doing here. One is we're waiting for our meat sauce to evaporate and taste to become more concentrated. And then the bechamel sauce naman, we're just waiting for it to become thicker. Show you how to assemble this. The moment this one is evaporated, I'm happy with the concentration it's in and the thickness of our bechamel sauce. Okay, I've achieved the desired thickness that I want. Now, I'm going to start assembling. Okay, first things first, let us remove the bay leaf. Yung bay leaf will float eh. Okay. You know, before, we used to have lasagna noodles that you had to boil, no? Now we don't have that. It's convenient in the sense that you don't have to bake it anymore. So, the moment you add it, it becomes nice and thick. So, let's get some of this bechamel sauce first. This is, we're talking assembly na, no? Okay. And then, we put in our lasagna sheets. Yum. Yum. Then we'll get some meat sauce. Yeah, flavor, that's whole flavor. So you imagine the savory flavor of our meat sauce and the creamy texture of our bechamel sauce. Wow. Now then we add in our sheets again. Yum. Okay. One more. You know, you might look at the pasta and think, oh my gosh, kulang. Because they're thin, but they're actually not. That's fine. Meat sauce again. You know, if you have leftover meat and bechamel sauce, make a smaller lasagna, di ba? Get a smaller baking dish and make something smaller. We just add it like this. Set cheese, a mixture of parmesan and cheddar. Okay, that's done. And we will bake this at 350 degrees, siguro mga 30 to 45 minutes. Okay. Ayan na. Our lasagna is done. Look at that color. Look at that beautiful color. It's very, very festive, di ba? You talk about lasagna, that's a celebration. Try it at home. Up next, my recipe for a sandwich that is fit for the festivities. Stay tuned to Casa Daza. My second home is Valle Verde Country Club. And one of the items they do very well is a sandwich called Monte Cristo. I love it. I'm going to try and duplicate that. A variation of the croque monsieur. To make the Monte Cristo, we will need sliced white bread, mayonnaise, ham, quick melt cheese slices, eggs, milk, salt, Japanese breadcrumbs, and oil. Now, what I'll do is I'm going to mix our eggs and some milk, okay? And we will just assemble this. Okay? Egg wash. And then salt. I have some cooking oil, some put butter. Standby yan. And then we will mix this. Okay? Mix this. Now, one color is what we're looking for, mixture of egg wash, milk, and egg with a little salt. We have some bread, American bread. What we will do is we will just cut the sides. You know, you can keep the sides if you want, but the original side of this is you cut the sides. But very, very thin. No? I mean, I don't like to waste your loaf bread. You set this aside, and I'll show you how to assemble one. Okay. So mayonnaise, and then, you know, one of the cheeses that I really, really enjoy and appreciate are our quick melt cheeses here in Manila. Ang sarap nila. Okay, so it's like distributing cards. Spread it all over and put some ham. Then mayonnaise. mayonnaise again. Little mayonnaise lang. Then some cheese again. Don't make it too thick also, you have to have a balance, di ba? Then one ham. Okay. And then the one with mayonnaise. At this point, what you want to do, Japanese breadcrumbs, okay, hot oil, and you just press down. You use a, ano, use a plate to flatten it if you want, no? Okay, flatten it. What you want to do here is slice it like a triangle. Okay, then dip it here. Dip it here. Ito na yung parang ano, French toast. Okay. Coat it with breadcrumbs all over. Yo. Yeah. And then fry it. You have to watch this, huh, because it turns golden brown really fast. Okay. And the moment it, remember, all of the ingredients are cooked already. So, diba? We're just waiting for this to turn golden brown and crunchy. And that's it. Yan. Then, let's check. Let's check. Okay. Yow. Okay. Fry like this. You stop the frying the moment you see all sides golden brown, actually. Now, you have to make sure that the oil is hot because we want to shock it and we don't want the bread to absorb the oil. Okay, this one is done. Actually, like I say, just the golden color we're trying to achieve. Let it drip a little bit. Yan. And put it on the side so that the underneath can breathe. Look at that. Yun. That's it. Monte Cristo, golden brown, crispy, savory. Your kids will love this and they're going to hug you and kiss you for this. Stick around for my special roast turkey recipe that's sure to be the highlight of any Christmas dinner. Only here on Casa Daza. Our third recipe, I'm sure, is so festive. Recently, we just had this celebration, Thanksgiving. This turkey is made by honeysuckle white. This comes from One World Deli. Alam mo, you look at it, parang ano eh. It's so huge, it's like an ostrich. Anyway, I'm going to show you how simple it is to make this recipe. Roast turkey with gravy. This juicy roasted turkey recipe calls for one whole honeysuckle white turkey raised by independent family farmers with care. No growth promoting antibiotics, added hormones, or steroids. Salted butter at room temperature, rosemary, thyme, seasoning liquid, sliced onions, sliced celery, and sliced carrots. To make the gravy, you will need the drippings from the turkey, flour, broth from the boiled turkey gizzard and neck. We will also add the chopped, softened gizzard, heart, and liver. Okay, what I'll do first is I'm going to make the rub. I'm going to melt some butter, salted butter to, one block of salted butter. I'm going to put some rosemary and thyme just to extract the flavors of the herbs, okay? Siguro mga, the moment the butter is melted, what we will do is this turkey kasi, look, may mga laman yan, there's the neck, and they have the gizzard, the liver, and all that. Get about 10 cups of water and about 4 cups of chicken cubes and boil that. And boil the gizzard also, and the neck, okay? Boil that, if you have a pressure cooker, 30 minutes, no? Now, what I've done with the liver and the heart is I chopped it up. So I'll get even the turkey butt. Sarap itong turkey butt na to eh. You know, this is my favorite, you know, because this is all fat, okay? This I'm going to boil muna with water and chicken cubes, no? Okay, set aside na yan. Look at this turkey, okay? We will tuck in the wings first. Okay, this like this. Okay. Yan. Okay. And then tie the legs. So I'm going to get some of this butter. Okay. Put it inside. Okay. Rub it all over. Remember, this is hot, but the turkey is chilled, so I can handle it. Okay. Rub it lang all over. Now, I'll strain the butter. Seasoning liquid. Okay. Now, get our turkey. Flip it like this. Okay, wow, look at that neck. Rub it all over. So this is flavored already. Okay. Just get this and put it here. Breast up. Get the butter. Rub it all over. So, carrots. Okay. With the butter. Celery. And the onions. Mix all of these together well. So, we're flavoring the vegetables also. What will happen here is it'll become very, very soft. And when it becomes soft, you can actually put it in a blender and include it in the gravy. Use your imagination. I'll show you how to assemble the gravy. And you know what? This is ready for the oven. Okay, I'm gonna bring it to the oven now. Turkey's done. You know what I've done is I removed the drippings and I'm going to save all these cooked vegetables and I'll show you how to make a gravy. You know, a roast turkey is so bland without the gravy. So the life really is in the gravy. Then you put, you know, yung cranberry sauce, mashed potato. But this is how I make the gravy. You remember how they make the sauce of a rellenong manok? It's quite similar. So these are the drippings from the gravy with the oil and everything. But you have to remember, it's flavored, remember? The drippings are flavored, diba? Okay. So we have to heat that. We'll add in some flour, okay? One thing I really hate is when you have turkey and you run out of gravy. This is flavored actually, no? But I have to cook the flour a little bit. Okay. Yan. I have some chopped liver from the turkey also. Okay, that was inside. Chopped gizzard, the tenderized gizzard. That's at the moment it's very, very thick. And then what I did is I flaked the chicken neck. Okay, look at that. And then I'm going to just add in the broth. And you eyeball it, no? Eyeball it. I can estimate this is still going to be so thick because I put a lot of flour and the drippings because I want to exaggerate the quantity of the gravy. Let me try it. Okay, now this is, it looks like it's going to be still a little thick. So what we will do, we will add in more broth. Ayan. And then season this with seasoning liquid. Siguro mga 3 tablespoons. Now, if it becomes too thick, then add a little more broth. But let me tell you, I assure you, this is going to be outstanding. Look at the color now. Anyway, let me try this. Boom. Yan. Some gravy. And some of the filling. Roast turkey with delicious gravy. You have to try this at home. for the holidays, how else can you find other festive dishes better than these? For the holidays, how else can you find other festive dishes better than these? Monte Cristo, lasagna, roast turkey with gravy. Look at this. Yun. Okay. Tayo lang natin ng konti lang. So look at that. Then we put some gravy. It's hot. Wait. Monte Cristo. Lasagna. Roast turkey. Try this at home. Merry Christmas and a blessed New Year. I love you.